Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Mike here, Game From Scratch, with a three-video day, thanks to Humble. That's right, there is a new Humble bundle of interest to game developers, so as always, I do a video as soon as possible to let you guys know if the bundle is right for you. The way Humble works is a collection of stuff, in this case books, ebooks specifically, and these are classics from O'Reilly Press. And these truly are some classic novels. Now, the downside is there's nothing really here for C# or C++ developers, but there is one book in this bundle that I absolutely recommend for everyone to buy, and fortunately enough, it's in the $1 tier. So for that reason alone, I am doing this video. But there's a lot of other interesting things in this bundle, maybe not specific to game development, but useful generally. So without further ado, let us jump in and take a look at what this bundle is all about. And as it goes with all bundles, you can decide how your money is allocated. You can choose between charity, between the publisher, between Humble, and if you so choose, and thanks if you do, to support Game From Scratch. So let's look at the bundle. They're always broken into tiers. And like I said, this one, the $1 tier, is where the sweet spot actually is in this case. And it is for this book right here, JavaScript, The Good Parts. This is a seminal book. This is a classic book. And if you hate JavaScript, and don't get me wrong, there's a lot of people that hate JavaScript, this is a book you need to read, because this actually is almost half of a book about why JavaScript sucks. And then the other half is about what is actually great. And if you need to work with JavaScript, this book may transform your view of the language. Now, let's keep in mind, the JavaScript was one of those languages that was written in something like 13 days originally. So there are some design mistakes, the mutability of this, the stupid equality operators, things that really trip up developers. This book really does a good job of explaining how to avoid the landmines and what you can really do to make JavaScript shine. So if you need to do any JavaScript development at all, spend the buck, get this book. It is excellent. So other than that, we have 97 things programmers should know. One of those things is to pick up JavaScript, The Good Parts. It's an excellent book. We've got Revolution in the Valley, How the Mac Was Made. Obviously, it's just basically a biography book about the Mac and the development culture around it. I actually read this a long time ago in the past, and it was an interesting and fun read. We've got The Cathedral and the Bazaar. This is Eric Raymond, kind of like the founder of the old open source movement, and this basically is Musings on Linux and Open Source by an Accidental Revolutionary. So this is sort of the handbook of open source. I've never actually read it, and I probably never will if I'm honest, but it is definitely an important book in the history of computing. And then we have Programming in Perl. If I'm honest, if I had to pick a language that I could obliterate from existence, it would probably be Perl. And the nice thing about that is if I killed Perl off, it would take PHP with it. So I personally am not buying it for that, but hey, it's got this book. So we jump up to the $8 tier. We've got some other interesting stuff here. We've got Java in a Nutshell, actually a fairly well-regarded book for Java. SSH, The Secure Shell, Git, Pocket Guide, Vi and Vim Editors. And by the way, if you are going to be learning Vi or Vim, you do want a book. It's amazing that for a text editor that you would benefit from a book, but you really would. It's kind of insane, but yeah. Hackers and Painters, Big Idea from the Computer Age. Then we go into the $15 tier. We get DNS and Bind, Data Analysis with Open Source Tools, Information Architecture, and then another book that I strongly used to recommend if you wanted to learn a programming language, but you want a very accessible, normal English language speaking book, this Head First series has always been excellent. And the Head First Java is also one of the most beginner-friendly books I've ever seen. Unless, of course, you find the humor grating, in which case you will despise this book. But once again, if you are at all interested in doing any JavaScript programming, this is one of those few books that I literally recommend to everybody, and it is at the $1 tier. And there's some interesting stuff here. Otherwise, it's a bit of a mixed bag. But again, some of these are real classic books in the industry, such as that one. And then the programming guides from O'Reilly have been always well-regarded. A little dry, but well-regarded. So it, again, a bit of a mixed bag. So if you're interested, if you do buy this pack, here is what you get. So the books come. You get every single book. Then the nice thing with Humble is it's your library. You can go back and download things as much as you want. You can also, if it is of the appropriate size, you can automatically ebook it over to your Kindle or email it over to your Kindle. So if you have a Kindle, you can use their free email receiving thing. I think it's limited to 5 or 10 megabytes in size, or you can download as PDF, EPUB, and MOBI. So that covers pretty much every single major format. Most of these are fairly small in size, so a lot of them should be Kindle friendly. But if you just want to, look at them on your iPad or in the browser or whatever, PDF format is pretty solid. And the cool thing here is all of these things also can be loaded directly from here. Unfortunately, apparently the browser I've set up can't read PDFs directly. But if you want, they are available to download this way. Let's head on back over here. So you can get back to this at any time whatsoever to get back to your books. And again, let me harp on this one more time. The book in here, you can actually buy it for $11, it looks like, from Kindle. The JavaScript, the good parts, again, a highly, highly, highly recommended book for me. And you'll notice from the ratings here on Amazon that there's 66% of the reviews are 5-star, and then 16% are 4-star. And then you've always got, 10 to 20% of the population that are idiots. So on the whole, this is a very good, well-rated book. I do highly recommend it. So again, it's a bit of an eclectic mix. At the very, very least though, again, if you're going to do any JavaScript development, pick up that $1 tier. It's worth it for this book alone. And this again is an amusing read. I will check out this book. Don't care. But there's a good collection of stuff here, and I actually have absolutely zero idea what Hackers and Painters is all about. So I may check that out at some point in time as well. Probably not, but it's there. And if you have any interest, once again, as learning Java, this is the most beginner-friendly book I have ever seen. So I'd like to know what you think of this bundle in general, and do you have the same experience as me? Like, I know some of these books are really classic, so a lot of people have read them. What do you think of the Head First series, and have you read JavaScript, the good parts, and if so, what did you think of it? Do you share my high level of recommendations for it? And don't get me wrong, this is not a book that is talking glowingly about JavaScript. It acknowledges the faults, and I think that's what makes it good. But let me know what you think of this bundle in general, and if you have any recommendations from it for other readers, I would love to hear them in the comments down below. And hopefully that's it for videos today. Three is enough, I think. Sorry to spam you guys today, and I will talk to you all later. Goodbye.